गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ सुजीत शर्मा, अ पीएचडी रिसर्च स्कॉलर ऑफ आईआईटी खड़गपुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर माय टॉपिक ऑन एन अप्रोच टू इन्वेस्टिगेट द इफेक्ट ऑफ रियोलॉजी ड्यूरिंग पॉलीमर एक्सट्रूशन यूजिंग कंप्यूटेशनल मेथड. दिस वर्क इज कैरिड आउट अंडर द सुपरविजन ऑफ प्रोफेसर शांतनु चट्टोपाध्याय रबर टेक्नोलॉजी सेंटर आईआईटी खड़गपुर एंड प्रोफेसर अर्गोदेव सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट आईआईटी खड़गपुर. Here I am going to give a brief description of rubber extrusion process and the problem arises during the processing. So extrusion is a process by which rubber compounds are forced through a die to get a desired shape of the product. Therefore here I have tried to depict the overall rubber extrusion and co-extrusion processes. Initially you can see raw rubber, filler and other additives are mixed in an internal mixer followed by two roll mill. Then the compound is fed to the extruder and forced through a die to get a desired shape of the product, followed by microwave and hot air tunnel for curing, then cooling, and finally cutting takes place according to our desired length of the product. The main problem rises over there during shaping the rubber profiles as die swell occur. This is basically due to one reorientation of polymer chain, and another one is the rearrangement of the velocity profile from Poiseuille to plug flow. So you can see there are a lot of rubber extruded profiles are there, especially in an automotive industries. The first work is published in Journal of Manufacturing Process and the second work is published in Chemical Engineering Journal. This is the overall simulation procedure depicted using a flow diagram. Here we have used computational fluid dynamics to analyze the structural instability of extruded due to die swell during processing. This computational method will help to visualize the fluid flow behavior even for complex die design as well as for complex fluid, and quickly generates an indicated set of results. So when we open the software, we will see these five sections: geometry, mesh setup, solution, and results. Initially, we need to prepare the model according to our desired profile shape, then divide it into our two domains, one flow inside the die and another one flow outside the die. Then we have to mesh the domain according to the geometry using different meshing method, type of element, and size of the element. In the setup section, we need to incorporate the thermal and rheological parameter of the compound obtained from experiments and curve fitting with the different models. Then we need to incorporate the proper thermal and flow boundary conditions, and finally remesh the domain which is going to be deformed. After completing the setup, we run the simulation and it solves the conservation equations to predict the flow pattern and extruded deformation. If the solution is conversed, then we analyze the different results, else we need to change the evolution parameter, mesh size, etc. and repeat the simulation once again. Here we have used standard instrument and ASTM to characterize the rheological and thermal behavior of the compound, followed by curve fitting to obtain the best fitted model for the simulation. These are the results which we obtained from simulation, like velocity, pressure, shear rate, viscosity, contour, streamline velocity, extruded deformation, and also we have detected the change in velocity profile from Poiseuille to plug flow. We have compared our simulated result with a complex shape automotive profile with the help of ALP Overseas Limited, a rubber profile manufacturer, and found more than 98% efficacy. Here we have predicted the shape of the extruded with the help of direct extrusion simulation. Finally, we have predicted the die shape according to our desired shape of the profile, which is shown in the right hand side. In the conclusion, we can say that the current era is moving towards the electronic vehicles and the demand of this type of product will increase. Thus, this work will help to reduce the traditional trial and error method for designing a die and also increase the production efficiency. Thus, by adopting this type of manufacturing technology, we can fulfill the future demands easily. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Also, I would like to thank ISR and IIT Gandhinagar for giving me an opportunity to present my work in such a clear platform. Jai Hind.